ground. I hear your trembling tootsies padding towards their final destination. Things come to those that wait, whether they want them or not. And soon, I think your wait will be over. The great metal door in reality is calling you, just as the Reaper beckons me forward. I look forward to finally greeting you. I only hope I need not greet the Reaper man first. Unless my friends lie somewhere near you now. A friend in need is a friend indeed. But a friend that's dead is a poor conversationalist. May they rest in pieces, ruptured, decomposing pieces.
Thank you.
Ah, only the engraving etched in the back of my mind can compare to the sight you must be seeing. Now power has returned. I wish I could be there with you, but circumstances do not allow for such frivolities. Maybe soon there is something you can do about that. But tell me, are the rubber-belted conveyances now churning in the dock room? I think I know what they need. It is some kind of heaven or a utopia. Now such good and lasting friends. I have gifted you with my love. Perhaps you could gift me with something. After all, the laws of politeness would be shattered if you were to appear at my party without a gift. Poor Red is so hungry. He could eat both the horse and the young rippling stable hand. Simply, pony flesh is so hard to come by in these parts, and man meat is so... just so bland. If your eyes happened upon a scurrying rodent, would you deliver the crunchy feast by way of a final meal? while you hunt for those delicate, melt-in-your-mouth mousy morsels, there are places you should not go, for fear of death. The Reaper lives here, just like you and I. And just like you and I, he must ingest the living flesh of those less fortunate than him. There is a small place that I do not want you to visit, even on your holidays, because it is dark and evil place that I've been. When the darkness has overwhelmed my small decaying mind, some bad things have flowed from my mind and through my pen. The brilliant blue ink itself seemed to turn to blood and to my grace. And by the way, should you turn peckish, red is at its finest sautéed with a little engine oil.